What's going on, everybody?
Hey, y'all.
We are back. Woo! Yes, it's Drinks and Conversation.
The podcast.
Yes, and I'm Intro Picks, and I'm always in the building.
And I'm Oxytocin, and it's always going down.
What's going on, Oxytoce?
Everything's going on, man. Everything.
We got a special guest in the building.
You know it.
Hey. Yeah, I give a warm welcome to Evan. Is in the building. Hey. What's up?
Hey, hello, everybody. How's everybody doing?
Don't ask y'all. Talking to the mic.
Hello. Hey.
I'm about to say it.
Because she was turning up before she got on.
I know, she turned up just a second
now
ago.
Now she's like, okay. Hey. I'm like, hold on. Who that?
Right. Let me stop playing.
How was your Christmas?
Yes.
My Christmas was awesome. You know, it was a blessing to be with my family, my son. He enjoyed himself.
Aww.
You know, he got with the eggs. Well, you know, he was deserving of it, so I was happy. So that's all that matters.
Now, what did you get for Christmas?
A little bit of this, a little bit of that.
Special gifts. Can't name them gifts. They're secretly wrapped gifts.
Can't even be wrapped. Those gifts.
What about you, Oxytocin? How was your Christmas?
Oh, my Christmas was good. I didn't spend it with my family this time around, though.
Really?
I let my daughter spend it with her father's side of the family. So I was there for a little more than half the day. Then I went home and finished the rest of my family. So it was good.
Okay. So you was kind of like kid-free a little bit this Christmas?
No, I was with her.
Oh, you was with her?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Where the child goes, the mother follows.
Okay, all right. Ain't no China Kardashian stuff around here during the Christmas time, right?
That's now, how was yours, though?
My Christmas was great. You know, I got the new Fire Stick, so I was at home just watching
you
movies.
You just got
stuff.
That?
Yeah.
Like, nah, let me stop.
I know, right? Yeah, I just got it. I'm a little late with it, but they've been selling out like everywhere.
Yeah,
so.
Because as soon as the movie starts streaming on there, you can get movies like really, really quickly on there and at really, really good quality, I heard.
Yep.
What's up? Can I borrow your Fire Stick or how are you doing?
Nah, you can't borrow the Fire Stick.
See, that's
I'm going to have to get you your own.
That's fine.
Next
too.
Christmas.
Next Christmas. No.
You gotta wait a whole year.
I mean, they have a new one.
You know, I got a birthday coming up, so.
Oh Lord, we still talking about this birthday. When's your birthday?
August 28th.
And so you're a what?
Virgo.
You're a Virgo.
Virgo.
Okay. Do you believe in horoscope signs? And
no, not really.
But not at all. You don't believe there's no truth to.
I mean, I've never seen a coincidence within my own mind to say, oh, yeah.
Got you. But I bet when Virgo season roll around, she'd be like, Virgo season!
Right? That would ask me.
Right.
I believe in.
You believe in anything.
I believe in. I'm a Scorpio, so I believe in, of course. You know.
See, right, because
yeah, I'm a Scorpio, so I believe in it. I believe that you could tell a lot by somebody's sign. Are you caring?
Yes.
All right, then. See, Virgos
that
are caring.
That is so basic. That is so basic that I can't even find the correlation.
Listen,
between what you're trying to
know. Sometimes it just.
Everybody is caring.
No,
okay,
but Virgos are extra caring.
Sure. How do you measure? How you measure that extra caring? How's that measured?
I don't know.
I know.
But they are. All right. That's how it works. Anything planned for the new year?
Nope. You can tell by that long arm. Like, I'm doing nothing. I'm going to be in the house. No. I might go out. I've just not decided yet. Let me say that. I have options. What I'm going to do.
What's the option? Like, tell us. Won't nobody know.
We'll help you figure it out.
we'll help you figure out what you're doing.
Okay.
So, one option is to go.
Talk to the mic a little bit so
okay,
we got to
option,
hear you.
I'm sorry. One option is to go out with one friend of mine. So you know what I'm saying? Who I'm digging. But not a whole lot. So, you know.
Okay. That seems like you only got one choice, right?
No, but if you're not digging him a lot, you know, when you take somebody out for New Year's, y'all do the New Year kiss. That go my
the New Year's kiss,
right?
You know, the midnight kiss, you know.
Right.
The midnight kiss. Oh, no, let me tell you, is this really a thing?
the kissing at midnight?
Yeah.
You never kiss at midnight?
I mean, you kiss all like the time.
Right, but it's something like the special moment.
I mean, I guess for your first time. Well, I mean, if you go into the new year with that person, it's expected that you're just going to be with that person?
No.
Why not?
That a known expectation?
I'm just saying, if you go into the new year.
If y'all do the New Year's kiss. Now, if you go through the new year, you don't do the New Year's kiss. There's no expectation.
So what's the New Year's kiss? It's like
when you kiss at midnight and you come into the new year together. It's almost like jumping the broom, but it's not. You know what I mean?
It's almost like jumping the broom.
But it's not. Yeah. Just make sure, look, you in a relationship. So okay. You make sure your lips is greased. And if you go out with him, you do the same because it's just, you know, y'all talking. You
now, what if it's in a club and it's at the new year and you just drunk
ain't no,
and
you
just.
You can do the kiss anywhere as long as
they're going to announce
stroke of midnight.
Gonna, like, you know, the stroke of midnight, everybody's going to do the countdown.
Yeah.
So,
okay. 3, 2, 1. Mm. Girl, you're in the new year's kiss. Come on.
I ain't going to be kissing nobody, but shit, I wish.
Well, you know who is coming into the new year with probably good kisses and hugs and extra gifts? We talking about Drake and J-Lo.
Yeah. Now, Drake they posted this picture. They already
started. Right. Yeah, well, right. We don't know. All right.
Did you see that
picture? No, we seen the picture, but that's just the picture. And did you see the way he was looking in the picture? Real creepy eye. Like
when his lips that close to your neck and you cut.
Yeah, that was a special
started.
Y'all are jumping the broom right about now.
Like, let me tell you, that picture said like everything. Like we're together, we're doing it,
right,
we're
like,
happy.
No,
that's what it said to me.
That picture didn't say that. Picture showed
it was written right across the bottom of the photographs. Yeah,
I was about to say in captions.
right.
That picture just showed. What I mean, it could say that. All right, but what I'm saying is one picture. They might not be together. Like, yo, it might just be, you know.
But this is the picture shown.
She was lonely one night.
So many stories have been following up to this. You see what I'm saying?
He came to her show.
Right. It wasn't like it was like, pie, picture. Hey, y'all, be together. No, like it led up.
It was subtle. It was subtle, but it was there.
Yeah.
The rumors was only there because he was attending her. Her shows and stuff.
So that's what we said. They let us know, like, all right, you know, when he start coming to your show, like, this is Drake. He got stuff he could be doing. He got money he could be making.
Right.
So this is not regular people who got time.
He do this all the time. He chase after bitches all the time.
You think he what?
He chase after girls all the time.
That's fine. I'm not opposed to a guy chasing after a girl, and I'm not opposed to women chasing after men. Because I'm a woman, I don't like recognize that double standard. I think it's fine. Go after what you want. And as far as women too, they can do the same thing. Him and J-Lo are perfect for each other. That's what they do. It's J-Lo. Like, that's what they do. She been around. He been around.
Let me tell you something. I will say this, though. If he is with J-Lo, man, wife that joint up. Like, wife it up.
But they... I don't
lock
even think
it in. Like, J-Lo is a catch. Like, catch that joint.
No, J-Lo is hard to catch, okay? She's been married. She already been divorced.
No,
like, he ain't catching that.
She's easy to
she
catch.
She don't want
to
be caught. J-Lo is not. That's just
oh, yes, she
them.
Do.
That's just
why you think
them.
She stay in these relationships?
Because, like anybody else, we love companionship. Why does anyone get into a relationship? It doesn't change because she's J-Lo. Shit, she just got access to the best niggas. That's it.
Well, I wouldn't say the best.
She does. Let me tell you,
she does. Right.
I didn't say she had them. She just has access to the best niggas.
With some money.
Right.
Access. Shit, nigga, that's access.
What you think, Eva?
I think as far as J-Lo and Drake goes, that was a... I don't know. I think they're really together. I think that they really like each other. I think he plans to go to her concerts for a reason. I mean, it could be a publicity stunt, but who knows? You know? Like.
So we just going to ride with it?
For right now, because we don't have nothing else to go on. Like, whatever receipts do we have?
But they both did post the picture, so.
Yeah.
They did both.
That means they decided on which picture to post. You know how many pictures they probably took? I'm like, no. Let's do that one. Oh, my. No. I like this one.
Like their official coming out picture.
You look good in that one. That's postable. Let's post it. So
now, what happened to the little dude she was dating?
Casper. He's done. He's Casper. His ass gone.
Don't they have kids together?
He disappeared. Here. No. No, the kids were kids with Mark Anthony. Oh, and Mark Anthony is a huge celebrity in his own right, especially to the Latin community. So, yeah. I mean, like I said, access. You know, she's not with no regular Joe Schmo. You know, right, so. No.
Drake, lock that joint down if you can.
No, I don't even think it's going to go that far. I'm for grown people, you know, being in a relationship, knowing what they want and getting what they want. And I think both of them understand what their situation is. So they just ran it out. Do I see them getting married? No.
No. I don't see that happening.
So then what's the point of being together?
That's their world. That's for them. They're different. I feel like if you want to be married, be married. If you don't, don't. If you want to have a boyfriend forever, have a boyfriend forever. You want to have a girlfriend, you want to be single, be single. It's your choice.
But we know that's not the reality when it comes to
that. That is the reality.
That's good press, though.
Listen, J-Lo, she likes to be married. She likes to be with
him. Did she tell you that?
She does.
That is your assumption of J-Lo.
She said it.
No. She didn't say
She likes to be in.
So why didn't she stay married? In relationship to be married. Because
she's not going
to
pull up. She's not going to put up with some shit.
What was it, though? Was it married or relationship?
She liked to be in relationship.
Who doesn't? Right. We already went over that.
All right, then. And be married. She married.
And now it's and be. See, you're switching up. You're switching up.
How many times has she been married?
She's been married like
a good three
six.
That I'm sure of. A good two almost. A good three marriages. A good two almost marriages. Okay. So I mean, that's life though.
She
likes her options.
Yeah.
She likes to have
them. And a woman should have them. Should have options.
Okay. Y'all should have options.
I mean, it's not stopping people from coming. They can take over suit.
It's definitely not gonna stop people from coming. Yeah.
Mm. Well, I wish them the best.
Not all relationships are looking so good like Drake and J-Lo. You got Tiny and T.I.
I'm actually happy for
and Tip. All of them. All three of them.
I'm actually happy for her.
Why are you happy for her?
Because I feel like she made the decision for herself. And I feel like we all know how T.I. has been.
How has T.I. been?
He's been cheating on her. When he goes from city to city, from town to town, and when I'm with her, I'm with her, and I treat her well, but being monogamous is not something that he's willing to do, but that's something that she wants. So she got tired of it.
And who said she wasn't cool with it? Was she cool with it?
You know what? I don't think a woman can ever be cool with something like that, unless she's doing it too. But I don't think you could ever be cool with that. Who wants to share that? Do you want to share your woman with multiple men?
I mean, no, you don't, but...
I'm saying, okay.
But if that's something that you agree with and you was okay with, you understand,
no,
like, that's the lifestyle.
No, I think sometimes you agree to things that you think you're okay with, but then after a while you realize that, no, that was I'm not okay with this.
Or maybe she like, nigga, you getting too old to be still.
Even when he married her, it was like, it wasn't like, I love you, you're the woman for me, I want to be with you. It was like, we might as well. We've been together this long. If I'm going to marry anybody, it's going to be you. Like, I'm just like... I don't know. I think she wants more out of a husband than what she's getting. And you have a right to leave. Fuck it. You have a right to leave. You don't have to stay.
Well, actually, you are supposed to stay. But
you don't have to.
I mean, you don't have to. You don't have sometimes to. You shouldn't. But at the same time, you go into it thinking that. I don't know. What do you think?
One. It's a hard decision no matter what she's going to do. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So they have been together for so long and they have three kids together. And she's taking his kids, his older children, as her own as well. So they definitely had a family bond. Mm-hmm. I feel like they both did their dirt. He cheated on her, but she also stepped out on him. So we can't say if it's good for the gander, it's good for the goose. If you're going to do it, don't expect that it's not going to be done to you. You know what I'm saying? So if you chose to stay afterwards, you stay. But if it continues to happen and you figure, like, okay, I don't want to deal with this anymore because obviously you're not going to change your ways, then you go on. You move on. Like, I believe. I left. You know what I'm saying? So it's a personal decision. And no matter what she makes, you're always going to second guess your decision. You're going to have those what ifs. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? What if I say, would you have changed for real? Would it have been better? But then you are not showing me that from your actions. So then, no, I don't. she should do what's best for her.
She definitely didn't enter into it lightly. I think she was sure. I think she thought about it. I don't think she's like, I'm just going to force his ass. They've been together for a long time. I think she really thought about her the pros and cons, and she made her decision.
But is it so much that she's probably just like, okay, well, I'm going to file for this divorce to show you that, nigga, I'm not playing.
It
like,
can't be.
You know what I'm saying? But not really go through with it, or don't really want to go through with it at the end of the day.
Divorce is just a process. It takes a long time. So that could happen. They could start the process and they realize it's not what they want. But she started the process, so that's all I have to go off of.
Right. But I think by the way, they're both of them will be judged because they're the public eye.
Oh yeah,
yeah. So it's hopefully it ends well for them. Like nobody wants to see a family split.
Divorce ain't easy.
How tough is a divorce? Like, from your experience, how tough? Put it into words. Like what? Like how tough is a divorce really?
Yeah, you can compare it to grief because you go through all the stages of grief. The denial, no, we can work it out, you know. Even though I don't see it changing, we can work it out. So then you go on to the other several stages of grief. And it takes a long time, I would say that. I would say that you go through phases. You go through your happy, you go through your sad, you go through your angry. That angry is a mother. But you can get through it. Like, you get through it, you have to get through it. Hell, you can't just stand in it and be like, this is where I'm going to be. This is all that I am. You move on.
So what is one of the biggest things that you think causes divorces? And what are some of the things that you think causes divorces today?
Miscommunication, finances, and being stagnant. One growing and the other not.
Wow. Not growing. Yeah. In the same direction or together?
Both. You have to want to grow together before you can grow anywhere else.
And what makes you say this is it? What are some of the things that would constitute as I gotta get a divorce?
Think that's something that you would have to decide on personally. Like, I can't, what's grounds for divorce for me is grounds for divorce for me. Like, I can say, okay, cheating, disrespect, abuse, I think those are common grounds for divorce. But some might not like the way that you handle your finances. So they'll leave you for that. Some might not like the way that you appear to others in public. You know, like, persons like dumb stuff. People get divorced now for anything. Like, love ain't with it yet, what it should be. Like,
so, would you get married again?
Yes.
You would get married again. That's great. What have you learned from your past experiences that you would do better going forward if you were to marry someone again or be in a committed relationship again?
The advice that I would give myself, I would tell myself to be kind. Be kinder with my words. So easily.
I just said that the other day. I really, really did say that the other day. Like, sometimes in relationships, you really, like, you know, sometimes I'm really blunt with a lot of stuff. Like, you know, sometimes I could just be just careless with my words. But sometimes, you know, you got to be a little bit softer. A lot of times, especially when you're dealing, you know, with women and stuff like that, you got to use, you know, be softer. Softer in your words, you know. So I was just saying that the other day.
That's great advice for someone listening to know that to, you know, be kind with your words and how you.
Yeah, because I would like
to someone else.
You don't want nobody to talk to you in a certain tone or a certain context. So why would you do that to somebody else?
Absolutely.
Why would you make them feel that feeling? You don't want to feel like that.
Well, I think sometimes you get comfortable with the person that you're with. Like,
but you still should always take their feelings into consideration. Try to be empathetic, you know, try to see, view it how they view it, see how they feel about it.
Right.
Go that extra step of caring, you know? But that's dope. That's great advice. Because, man, this mouth can be so sweet, but this mouth could be so sharp, you know?
Woo!
So, Absolutely. I'm single, so I don't got to worry about that right now. But that's good to know. It's good to start working on it.
So is the dating scene going to change in 2017? I mean, like, what?
How is
what,
it now?
I mean.
It's weird. Like, okay, so being with somebody from the time you're 16.
From Tinder?
Swipe left or right? No. Like, okay, well, let's say most dating now is online. Like, nobody's meeting nobody at the gas station. Like, randomly you have those moments.
Right. But you can meet somebody at drinks and conversations.
You sure ahead. Can, because we don't hook the few people up.
Yeah. But back to what you were saying, I just had to throw that plug in there. Sorry about that.
Good intro. Like, but no, so most dating is online now. So getting used to that aspect, because like 10 years ago, we wasn't on the system like that. Like, I met you where I met you. I slid you my number, hey, and stuff like that. Now we texting back and forth, but you don't like.
I think it starts off like that. Like, when you meet somebody on the internet, you know, you start off in the DMs. That's like the first days, and you switch over to the number, then you start texting all day, then you might call at night, and then you be like, yo, let's meet up for something to eat
meet
at.
Meet up. Yeah. We're having a FaceTime.
You know, or you can FaceTime. Yeah. Not everybody
let
got.
Let me see if you look like your picture. But they got a lot of things. You can get Glide, Marco Polo. Yes. Like, it's not just
the iPhone. After text message, then we're going to insert that. After text message is FaceTime.
Yes.
And then you meet up
got
with
to
somebody.
Make sure you look like your photos.
And then GTD.
You are so stupid. My
you
goodness.
Get the girl.
No.
Right.
That is but it really do go down like that sometimes.
Is that how it went down for you?
Nah, it didn't go down like that for me. But I'm just saying, I had little stories, you know what I'm saying? little bonfire stories that I heard. Right.
Bonfire stories. I hate you. Oh my gosh. Man, but let's go ahead.
No, go ahead.
We're not going to do this. I think go ahead.
Go ahead.
We fighting. That's
You know, you want
to
fight before 2017. Do you want
to
fight before 2017?
I'm about to trade songs this whole studio up in here.
Oh, let me tell you
something. Up in here. Yo, Trey. Tremaine. Yeah, that's that Virginia in him, young. I'm trying to tell you.
That was all an act. Come on. You damaging your own equipment.
That wasn't his equipment.
Oh, who equipment? Well, he knew he was going to pay for it.
I hope he got the money. I don't know.
Nah, he got the money.
He does. Because, you know, they be in these contracts. Then you find out 10 years later they didn't have no money. And they was getting robbed. And they don't have nothing to show for their success. I mean,
he is looking a little rough out here.
He growing his hair back. So it may be, you know, something going on. But you can't be out here acting like that. When clearly, like, it's just like 1 + 1 = 2, Trey. Like, you were over your time. We're going to cut your mic. Like, why do we got to go through all this when you know what's good? And it's not like you on your own tour. Like, this is not the Mr. Tremaine tour. There are other people here. And y'all have to share this time. You knew that beforehand.
If they were smart, they would have bought their own mics. And they would have bought the... As soon as they would have cut the stage mics off, you bring out the portable Bluetooth speakers. And you
nobody
just put
in the back going to hear your ass. You might as well be performing in your living room.
Like, what'd you say?
And now he's in jail. They got him on charges, obstruction of justice, resisting arrest. They got him on all this stuff.
He out now.
Like, for what?
Maybe he wants to go to jail for
it. This is so unnecessary. Like, you are an R&B dude. Like, just sing, shawty. Just sing when you're supposed to sing and get off the stage when you're supposed to get off the stage. That's it.
I feel like he didn't think that they were going to do it. He didn't think that they was going to shut them lights off for him. So he was like, let me go ahead and test the limits. Yeah, I dare you. And I'm going to sing it in the tune. And
he was like, I can't look like no punk. I can't
right,
look like
I
no
can't
punk.
I can't go out like that. Nah.
And they cut it.
It was
that's
like,
so
today.
No,
these venues don't be playing, though.
They don't.
No. We even have our little tit for tat with drinks and conversations. Like, these venues do not be playing. Like, yes. When they want you out they shit, they want you out they shit. They don't give a fuck who it O-U-T. Is or not. Because they got to be there after your ass leave,
yep.
cleaning up and fixing up and all types of shit.
And it's about respect, too. Like, you know what I mean? I'm sure they have a contract. Like, it's about respect. Respect my time. Respect my craft. Like, respect my venue. Like, come right. on.
I would have put all that.
It was a little bit funny to watch. I'm not going to lie. I felt bad for him as well, but it was extremely comical. I got a good laugh. I was like, what the hell is going on? Like, is this real? I didn't know if he had a body double or what. He was just going off, and I'm like, for what? Like, did anybody hurt your mama? Like, what is
maybe
it?
Maybe Trey Songz is going through something.
I believe so. I believe so.
Like, maybe his record's not selling. He, you know, he might be a little bit past doing a couple car notes. I don't know. So maybe he's going through some stuff. He is looking rough out here.
Something. I mean, I just, it was, you cannot, it's just certain things you just cannot do. And that's one of the things you just cannot do. I wish I would go to my job and be mad and think my day job at that and think I'm going to be up in there tearing up some stuff. I'm going to be gone. You can't do that. You could tear up your own stuff. Now, if he want to go to his house, now he's all fine and break his flat screen TVs and mess up his china. But you want somebody else's house. Show some respect.
The job do be making you want to tear up some stuff. I ain't going to lie. You be ready to break something up in that joint.
And be ready to go to jail because they not going to play.
They not going to play. Because, you know, I was on live the other day, Evan, and I was talking about, you know, I've been in a corporate job for about over 10 years or so, and I just hate the politics with corporate offices. Like, it's just like you just have to kiss ass. You just got to kiss ass. You got to do work, but you got to mainly kiss. It's about 90% kiss ass and about 10% work. So, and I just be sitting there like, yo, this is so not me. This is so not, like, who cares, you know? So I was just venting the other day, you know, as far as that goes, you know. I don't know. I've been working a long time, you know.
I know. So, I see your gray hairs and coming. Whatnot. It's they coming out. It's like, no, you don't have no, you don't have no hair. But no hair. Pretty much.
But I might get some chin. I don't know.
If you get gray hairs, would you pluck it out?
Yes. I don't know why. I don't know why people
get
don't pluck out their gray hairs. Like, well, you think I'm gonna keep one gray hair on the side?
Why don't you just dye one? Because you pluck it out, dye one back, and it's gonna come back thicker and stronger. You can put a little black dye and then, you know, permanent.
Get
dye.
A like, Sharpie. Put a Sharpie.
You could do that too, but it just makes no sense to pull it out because it's gonna come back thicker and stronger.
So you cannot dye one.
Yes, you can. You just go. Just leave it there. And just let it sit for about a month.
I got some on the other way.
It ain't going to hurt the other ones. You can't. Dye that. Don't pull it out.
No, the other ones is going to be blacker than. Because, you know, that'd be like jet black.
That's why you just got.
Ain't no such thing as.
One. Like, you could do it with a Q-tip or something.
When have you dyed?
I don't. But, I mean, if I did have gray hair, I would just dye it.
What would you do?
I would rock it.
Do you rock the gray hair?
I like it. It's pretty.
Really?
Yeah, I've always thought it's pretty. It's like it's distinguished. Like, I'm almost somewhere. I got one gray hair.
You think it's wise? People say gray hair wise. No.
Make you look like you got a little bit of wisdom in
you. You got a little, like, a little bit of wise.
Like, you know a little something.
If I got one, it got to go.
Listen.
But I do like when I see older women, especially African American women, though, and all I like the like everything got to be uniform, like all gray. Like when it's like some.
But Tosa, what makes you want to think you? What makes you think you want to dye your whole head jet black because you got a few couple gray hairs?
I said I would dye the strand, not all of my hair.
But it's gonna stand out. You're going to have one
jet black.
My hair's
like three different colors now, and it's fine, so. It'll be good.
I don't know.
I
don't
want to
grow up.
I can go in any color, but I just won't cover it up. It's going to be cooked. Going to be cooked.
I have seen people with gray hair, and I do like the whole gray black girl magic movement that's going on across the globe. I do like that. I've seen it quite a few.
Yeah.
And, yeah. And you know, I want to bring up. Have you seen the new issue? I forgot the girl's name, but she has vitiligo. She's a model. And let me see if I
Winnie
can
Carlo.
Up. Yes. Yes. So she just graced the cover of, I want to say it's Ellie magazine. Mm-hmm. And I'm just loving the diversity that I'm seeing amongst models, especially models like her. Because I've had a couple of friends who've had that skin condition and are just really like beautiful people, you know? And I'm just like, it's a shame that before we couldn't see that on a massive scale as we do now with people like her that's actually making a movement like that.
That's cool. I mean, you know, self-love, it's cool, but I don't know.
What you mean?
I mean, I just don't know. I just, okay, so some, like a month ago, 2 months, whatever, she got caught talking negatively about another model on her Snapchat. She was just being really, you know, negative. And for someone who has vitiligo, who has a skin condition, who talks about being bullied, talks about not being accepted, and I'm not saying she's perfect, but just to turn around and do the same shit that you're blowing up off of, it's just, I don't like that hypocrisy. I don't like being a hypocrite. Like, so are you for it or not? Like, what is your, where are you going with it?
So I feel like people
have said that about her. Like, she only does it because it suits her and that's her only way in. They say she's a nasty person. I don't know. I've never met her. But that just showed me, like, okay, are you true? Do you really mean this? Are you doing it for the likes? Are you doing it for the money? Like, I don't know.
That is,
kind of left a bad taste in my mouth about her. And I was really rocking for her since she was on Top Model. Like, I followed her on Instagram. I thought it was great. But then to find out, like, you phony? Like, right. I don't like that. I don't like that.
What you think, Gavin?
Yeah, you shouldn't live that double standard, especially if you live through something that you know other people are going through, and then you turn around and you do it to somebody else. Like, again, do unto others as you want them to do unto you. You know, I greatly believe in that. I think that's a very strong thing to live by. You know, because you don't want nobody to treat you whack. Why would I treat you whack?
And she did apologize. Let me put that out there. She did come back and say sorry, but only because people was going in.
Yeah,
people
was
going in.
Yeah,
I mean, like, your whole career is this. But you turn around and was exactly that. Like, but I just wanted to say she did say sorry.
Right.
You know, that what can you do?
That's like
my
mama told me I had to, so.
Yeah.
Let me go. I'm sorry. You know, like, I really don't mean it, but.
That could be true because, you know, people's perception, like, especially in Hollywood and being famous, is totally different than how they really are, you know, in person.
Right.
So sometimes she might not be like that. But I hope not, because she is doing something, in my opinion, that I think is pushing the envelope,
yeah.
You know, as far as that goes. It's just showing, like I said, at the end of the day, diversity. And if I had a little girl or daughter who had that type of skin condition, I'm glad that she can see a model that is just as beautiful and is just up there doing a thing.
There's,
you know what I'm saying? It's important.
With vitiligo, she's like,
it's
dying.
A couple.
She's doing her little thing. I wish I don't know her name though, but I mean, it is good.
Here.
They are knocking down doors and breaking down barriers, you know. And just don't ruin your legacy over something like that. You know what I mean? She really, like, she took herself some steps back with that. I hope she can recover. I really hope she, you know, does the self-reflection that she needs to do so this doesn't occur again or so she can work on herself.
Right.
But, you know, it just left a really bad taste in my mouth. Like, I was really rocking with you and it's like, damn, so this is fake. You're not who you claim to be, Sway.
Right. Everyone has that moment. You know,
yeah.
We all have our days. And
absolutely.
Unfortunately, hers was just publicized because she is in a public eye. And
yeah.
On a public platform. You know, you got to make better decisions.
Absolutely. That Snapchat to get you. You think that shit got in 24
yeah.
hours.
It's fun to go live until you go live.
Yeah. They was, right. I thought it was gone. How I heard Snapchat everywhere. Everybody
right.
Playing it on.
Man, this is the internet age. Everything goes on the internet. It's
everything.
Crazy.
And you can't take nothing off, even your 24-hour snap.
Right.
So snap wisely, folks. Snap
yeah.
wisely.
Right. Put on there what you want. Just some people to see. But also that posted up on the internet. Let me tell y'all about this video. I don't know if y'all seen it, but it was a video of a girl. And she was literally, she beat up her boyfriend. because she got some type of text messages or something that was on WorldStar. I mean, it's been going viral. Well, first of all, was that a girl?
I didn't watch the video, but I heard about it. And I'm not for anyone being in an abusive relationship, whether it's a woman beating a man or the man beating a woman. You got to go. But I heard the whooping was very severe. Like, it was no joke. And, you know, you just got, like, just leave the person. Honestly, like, you can't just be hitting people and hurting people like that.
I said, why didn't he run?
Was he able to run? Or did she, like,
was mopping him. She was mopping him. She was molly whopping him a couple of times. But he had a couple of times to probably get out of Dodge. Yeah. But, you know. And then whoever the friend wasn't no good because she was mad about the shit and then go say, beat him again. Do it again. And she did it again, like literally. And I was like, yo, this is a damn
shame. Are they still together? Because I heard it was really, really bad.
I don't know, but I know he was fucked.
If that happened to you, Intro Picks, what would you do?
It wouldn't happen to me.
But I'm saying if it did.
It wouldn't happen. I would have been gone. Let me tell you something right now. Even if you bigger than me and I don't want to, you know, mess you up or don't want to touch you like that. Like, yo, I'm going to be whoosh, whoosh. I'm going to be
whoosh, whoosh.
Out. I'm going to be out, yo.
Whoosh, whoosh.
Right, yeah. I'm a, like, somebody like that, I would have had to lock in a room and I would have had to wait until you calm down.
Wow. Do you think they're going to get married?
I don't think they're going to get married. That's some hood shit. All day. I don't even know if that was a woman.
For real. I don't think so.
Because she had hands.
No. Yeah.
Come here.
I'm not down for the abuse, but that just lets you know that niggas get beat up out here too.
We get beat up out here.
They always think it's
Oprah
one-sided.
Did a show in 2007. We knew men was getting beat.
Okay, but that was 2007. 2017.
They still getting beat.
They get beat worse. Ain't on camera.
How you know worse? Oh, you saw the video. Okay. Yeah, I mean, it's just sad relationships.
They like, get
if it gets
Molly
to that point, just walk away. Oh my gosh, it's not worth it. Like I don't even want to be with somebody I feel like I have to put hands on. I just feel like the relationship is just done and over at that point.
You know, a lot of people say, some people, they say, okay, if a woman that's in that situation, why don't they just leave? You know, I mean, that's the thought process. Sometimes they be like, well, the nigga's just beating you up, then why don't you just leave? But we also understand that it's a mental psychosis that goes with it, you know what I'm saying? And that prevents you from leaving. And I'm actually dealing with, you know, one person in my family in particular that is kind of going through something like that. And it's hard for me to try to explain, like, yeah, you need to leave. But, you know, you have to be patient enough for them to go at their own pace. But at the same time, you just want to just be like, yo, get the fuck on. Like, you got to get the fuck, like, at the end of the day. So it's just a hard little line, you know.
It's definitely hard, but I'm still going to tell you what you need to hear. Things that need to be heard sometimes aren't easy to say. I would try to figure out the best way to say it, but if it's me saying that you should consider leaving. Right. Leaving may be the best option. I mean, I'm definitely going to say it. Regardless if it's nice or not, or you don't want to hear it, or it's mental, I'm still going to put that out there in your brain and let it float, marinate, act on it, don't act on it, but you need to know. That's how I feel about that. It's just sad. It's so sad.
That's what good friends.
Yeah. I would tell you to leave even if you stayed. I'm like, you know you need to leave.
Now
you'd
be like, you can take that hit. That hit wasn't nothing, nigga. You can take that hit. No. This working. That's called love pain, growing pains, and stuff like that going on. You know what I'm saying?
So look. So let's say you both were in a relationship, right? And it's like after Thanksgiving going into Christmas. Should you stay in a relationship through Christmas and New Year's, or would you just let the relationship go if you wanted to leave? Do you feel obligated to stay through the holidays?
I say it depends on the mental hold that the other person has on you. You know, it depends on what you're going through, what they're telling you, you know, what you're being told to. It's a lot with that. I personally don't feel like you should stay because of no certain day. Like, that day you might not like to see.
Got you stretching?
I think you should just let it go right then and there. Ain't no point of spending no extra bread now, unless it's their birthday. If their birthday is coming up, wait until after their birthday. But if it's like around Christmas, Valentine's Day, all of that other shit,
leave them.
Leave them right then and there, because you ain't got time to be wasting all this amount of money. Now, maybe don't, because nobody, you know, sometimes you may want to be with somebody to Valentine's Day. You might be like, you know, after Valentine's Day. But see, the thing about that is, you fuck around and change your mind after a while. You be like, God damn it, things is good now. So I'm going to just stay.
Right, right.
And then you be like, shit. So, therefore, if you're going to let the shit go right. Way before then, unless it's around a birthday. It's mean to do it around, you know, a birthday.
Okay, I asked you guys that question because I was reading this article online about a woman who her fiance, as a matter of fact, Christmas gift, he's like a diehard Cowboys fan. So, she had got him tickets to the game. But her fiance broke up with her via text message just before Christmas. So she took herself to the Cowboys game and had a big old sign that said, "My fiance dumped me via text message. He should have waited until after Christmas." And then I started reading the comments and people was like, "You don't break up with nobody, you know, during Christmas. You got to stay. You obligated to stay." And they was like, "He missed out. He's so stupid." But I'm like, if you want to go, should you go? Should you stay for a Christmas gift? Like, is that what people are doing out here?
But she ain't tell about all the crazy shit she was doing underneath that damn sign. For a nigga to be like that, break up with your ass. We didn't give you no 2 weeks notice. Right. We didn't give you that shit. Sometimes, you know, when a job done fucked you up, you don't give them no 2 week notice. You just be out. You know what I'm saying? That's it. And you leave all the work that was supposed to be done for somebody else. That's it. You know what I'm saying? If she was good and she was cool and the relationship went smooth, then maybe we could have had a smooth transition. But other than that, you got.
He missed out.
What you think, Gab?
Cowboy ticket.
I don't think you should have to say. Don't say because you feel obligated to a date. Like, that's silly. Like, if it's not going to work out with you, it's not going to work out with you. Whatever you bought, you definitely don't have to give, and you always have a receipt, so you can always return it.
I don't think you can return no Cowboys. Can you return
them? I mean, but you can use them from yourself. Like, she obviously she went herself to the game and, you know, and enjoyed herself, but I don't want to see the purpose of that sign. My boyfriend dumped me. Like,
gotcha.
Go in and enjoy.
Who do you love? You love Beyonce. Who is your, like, ultimate artist? Was it Michael Jackson, or what's your ultimate sports team, or what's that?
Prince.
So, purple, if your fiance, who you wanted to let go, bought you some Prince tickets, but you knew about him for Christmas, would you stay to get your Prince tickets, or would you
Hell
go?
Hell yeah, she would stay. Looking forward to this.
I just right.
I sneak sale probably. I try to steal them first.
I'm going to steal them, take your gift, and leave you all at the same damn time.
Pretty much. Said
you, y'all,
said you gave them to me.
Right. I like how I found it.
That's so heartless, though. I'm going to take your tickets. I'm going to break up with you. And all at the same damn time.
Y'all trying to Kardashian it out here. Just taking every fucking thing.
The egos. She took the whole nursery. I just can't with his. Let me not even. I digress.
Let's not even go back there because they're back together now.
So bye-bye. 2016 is coming to an end. I want each of you to tell me, what are you leaving in 2016?
What am I leaving? What are you leaving? What are you leaving behind?
Stress.
Woo!
Okay. All right. You preach it.
Hey, I'm leaving stress, man. I got time for that. Girl, I got stuff to do.
She ain't saying nothing but a word.
I think I'm just leaving the petty shit behind.
No, like, you are not.
No, hold on. Not my petty shit. The petty shit that comes my way. Oh. Like, I think. Can't get that shit out. Like, I think I'm leaving, like, the petty stuff that comes my way. Like, I think I'm just, I don't have time. Like you said, I just don't have time for it. And it's like, if it's not about serious stuff, if it's not about making the quality of my life better, it's not worth my time. Basically, and that's it. What about you, Oxytocin?
You had me for a minute because you want, you know, petty, I was mother. To... I said lies. But okay, I got you. Man, what I'm leaving behind in 2016 has to be procrastination. I sit on things a lot. And I've accomplished a lot in 2016. I'm very happy with 2016, but I feel like it could have been better.
Right.
You know what I mean? So I feel like on 2017, I just have to be at the top of my game, and I'm just ready for what 2017 holds for me.
Okay.
I'm not so good about this. 2016 was good. Everybody talking about 2016 must have been a man. It was horrible. I'm like, yo, I had a good year, y'all.
I had a good
year,
too.
Like,
yeah.
My year was good. Like
I can't relate.
I can't either. I'm like, nah, I don't feel that way.
But you know what? 2017 is going to be even better. What? Listen, we are on Drinks and Conversation number 5. It's coming
five?
Up February 11th. This is
yes.
number 5.
I'm sorry.
Drinks
I'm
and Conversation
off it.
Number 5.
I'm off it. You didn't say the event. I was like, oh, yes.
It has been a great year.
It has
and we're going to make the best of 2017. And
woo!
Listen, they can say all they want about, like I hate when people say about New Year's resolutions, like, oh, you say the same thing every year. Listen, let us have our time to get our priorities in order. Right. All right.
Preach
so
us.
What? If we need a yearly reminder. All right. Basically. So
new me.
Right.
New
all
me.
Right. Right. Let me new have me. My little New Year's time and get my shit together and move towards some of the goals that I want to move
yes.
towards.
Yes.
And that's all
there is
going
to say. What goals? One goal. Not all your business, but just one.
Okay. So one of my goals is.
Uh-oh.
I think I want to do a music video.
Are you serious?
Yeah,
I think I do. I want to do one, too?
That's like a bucket list, actually. That's not
mine
a goal.
Too. I want to do like a 90s jump. Like need some girls.
Yeah,
all
I
want to
do
black
like a nice little throwback.
Like some SWB type. Yeah. I'm sorry. This is
okay.
Go ahead.
So when we collaborate. Yeah. So we,
let's
do it. Not just me.
Let's do it. Okay.
I think I did. Well, that's because I'm going through my 20 life crisis. I'm about to be 30. Sorry. But I think one of my major goals is. One of my major goals is just stepping my game up.
Amen.
Stepping it up. Stepping it up and just knowing that I spend less time sleeping and more time working.
Yeah.
Basically.
I need you to be on time.
And be on time.
Yeah.
And be more organized. all that good shit wrapped up in one in a nice slice of pie. So that's what I know. What about you, Evan? What you got going for 2017?
2017, I want to be fearless. I'm gonna jump out there and start my own business.
Woo! That's I gotta clap. I don't know if y'all hear me clapping, but I gotta clap for her about that. I'm so into entrepreneurship.
Owner.
Yes.
You know, I love a good
self.
Business.
Yes.
Work for yourself. Why work for someone else? Stop making other people money.
Okay.
What? Best of you. Team of me.
I know that's right.
Yeah.
What about you, Oxytose?
I just wanna take care of myself as far as like holy, like make myself a top priority. As far as like eating right, exercising, my health, my wellness, like really taking care of myself. You know what I mean?
Okay.
That's what I want to do. That's something that I don't do.
Okay.
I really like, I mean like when you really want to take care about yourself, you're conscious about what you're eating, you're conscious about what you're doing, you're feeding my mind, like just really taking care of myself from the inside out. That's my goal. See, I already started though.
I know it.
I already started, so it's just going to get better. Consistency is key. Just sticking with it. You know, not giving up and just changing my life. Lifestyle change. That's what.
And we're going to do it. Indefinitely. We're going to do it.
Yeah,
there's also a vision board party coming up if you're interested. I'm going to just throw that out there. January 14th. And it's good to just outline your goals and stuff like that. And for the new year, because it's important, you guys. And we want to hit it. And we will hit our goals and do what we have to do.
Yeah.
2017 is where it's at. This is Drinks and Conversations.
The last episode of 2016.
Yes, it is.
Yes.
And we got our guest, Evan, here
with
us. Thanks for having me, guys.
It was a pleasure.
It was a pleasure. Yeah. It was a pleasure.
Did we ask you what you like about Drinks and Conversations, the event?
The event, I love the open flow of conversation.
Mm.
The diversity of opinions. Just to hear everybody's perspective on the same topic. And that's really cool. And to be all in one space and to share. And it's fun. And people come out and we laugh and have a good old time. Like, it is really nice.
Wow. I love the way she said that. She said, there's a diversity of opinions. Woo! Yeah, I like that. Hey!
And that's what we want to bring. Absolutely. And you know, and we're going to see you February 11th. Absolutely. Loving relationships.
Yes.
And we're going to do exactly what we do every single time, but we're just going to put a little bit more love. A
little stank on that.
A little stank on it. And a little bit more relationship up in there.
Yeah.
So, you know, we're going to get it popping. Well, thank you for coming on to the podcast.
So much.
Yes. You. And we so enjoyed much. You.
Yes. Do you have any shout-outs? You want to give us somebody a shout-out or something?
Shout-out to you guys. This was awesome. Like, shout-out to y'all. I enjoyed myself.
Thank you. We are so glad that you enjoy yourself. And I took a hiatus from drinking. So the next time you come back, I'll probably be drinking again.
Listen. Go to episode number... I always talk about this episode. But we ain't going to bring it up. I'm going to spare you this one. But this is Drinks and Conversation.
The podcast.
Yes, and we are out.
Woo!
And Evan, you can come back anytime.
Yes, especially when that business get the pop and we got to have you
back. Promo.
Yeah.
We out, y'all. Hey.
You gonna wipe that sweat off your head for 2017? Don't bring that into the new year. Wipe it all off.
Wipe it off.
And bring that into the new year. Leave that in 2016, buddy. His head be shining like I don't know.